Sändningen från veckans NHL presenteras av McDonald's.
Coming up the next NHL Power Week.
Slutspelet är ju igång och vi följer det i veckans NHL.
The defense was changing. Good night there. Now a shot. They score! Miro Chatan! Ensign for Buffalo!
Möt Colorados lagkapten Joe Sakic som älskar spelet om Stanley Cup.
Playoff time is so intense. There's so much excitement going on around the game. It's just a lot of fun to play.
Ni träffar också de bästa europeiska målskyttarna.
The number one scorer in the league, Jaromir Jagr.
Don't blink, Stanley Cup style.
Oh, what an amazing stop by Hatchett.
I Western Conference möttes Detroit och Anaheim i första runda.
Stanley Cup playoffs are about to begin for 99 Detroit in defense of the cup. The Mighty Ducks come into this as severe underdogs. Do they have a chance? One of their fans says, hey, it's not yet duck season in Michigan.
I match nummer ett chockade gästerna de regerande mästarna.
Shot, Korea, save, Osgood, rebound, Rutschen, cover up, no, Backlund, McGinnis scores! The Ducks take a 1-0 lead!
Detroits lagkapten Steve Yzerman klev då fram och blev stor matchhjälte.
One-timer, Lundstrom just wide, rebound, score! What a no-angle goal by Steve Yzerman! Way out of the net, Askey getting back, score!
Fem 3 till Detroit i första matchen och i andra blev det ny seger efter 3 poäng av Brendan Shanahan. I tredje mötet fortsatte mästarnas storstjärnor att glänsa.
Back for a shot by Fedorov, he scores! Sergei Fedorov and the Red Wings have struck first on a long drive. Over to Yzerman. Yzerman creeps in, shot save, another shot, they score! Steve Yzerman with another huge goal.
And the Detroit Red Wings, the Stanley Cup champs, take a stranglehold as the Red Wings shut down the Ducks and the Ducks face elimination.
I första matchen mellan San Jose och Colorado hette banans kung Joe Sakic.
Olsevich, cross-ice pass, one-timer, Sakic scores! Great pass, great shot, 1-0 Avalanche.
What a pass by Sandis Olsevich.
Puck goes to Milan, Heyduke moves in, Sakic scores! Heyduke set up Sakic, it's 3-0 Avalanche. And game number one in this series is over. Patrick Waugh has become the first player ever to win 100 games in the playoffs as a goaltender. A 3-1 victory. It's the whiteout, the tradition carried over from the Winnipeg Jets. And add in all the barking, yelping and baying at the moon, and it's a spectacle for the ears as well as the eyes.
St. Louis veteran Al MacInnis knäckte snabbt både hemmapubliken och Phoenix i första mötet mellan lagen.
Head up, looking around, he's got Turgeon with him at the blue line, drills a shot, he scores! The hardest shot in the league, and Al MacInnis gives the Blues a 1-0 lead.
Oh, man!
Jamie Rivers avgjorde matchen, också det målet i powerplay, 3-1 till St. Louis. I match nummer två tryckte MacInnis till igen, från blålinjen på nytt.
Cornell charging in, comes back for a kick, blocks a big shot, and a score! And it's a 1-0 lead, another power play goal for the Blues.
I slutet av matchen låg samma MacInnis bakom St. Louis kvittering.
Cross ice, Al MacInnis again, it's that feed to Dimitri, scores! What a pass by Al MacInnis to Pavel Dimitra! We are tied!
Tic-tac-toe, what a pass by Al MacInnis.
I sudden death var ändå Phoenix starkast.
Shane Doan looking for another good offensive try. Jammed in! And the Coyotes win!
Coyotes win 4-3.
Starkt av den segern fortsatte Phoenix glänsa i match nummer 3.
Here's Reichel, into the slot, Gauthier scores! Now a drive score! Louis DeBrusque! The Coyotes win it 5-4.
Phoenix now leads the series 2-1. These teams will play a game in game 4.
I första matchen mellan Dallas och Edmonton gjorde Tommy Salos lag första målet, men det blev också Edmontons enda i matchen.
Matt Tkachuk with a shot in the crease, but then they score. towards the net. Here's Carpenter with a shot.
Guy Carbonneau blev alltså matchvinnare med sitt 2-1 mål. I andra matchen överlistade han Salo igen.
Two Stanley Cup rings and two goals now in this playoff series. Now it's Langenbrunner getting set back in. Shot is scored. Just a great backhand by Jamie Langenbrunner.
I tredje matchen vände Dallas ett underläge till ny seger.
Another one goal game. Ken Hitchcock's team coming back with three straight third period goals. The winner scored by Joel Nieuwendyk, and Dallas is one game away from advancing to the next round.
Möt nu Joe Sakic, inte bara superstjärna i Colorado Avalanche utan också restaurangägare i Denver.
Well, Joe, this is a very nice place you have here, but the menu is extremely interesting. You know, it's like I always knew that that Patrick Waugh was a great goalie, but here we now have two dishes that you guys have decided to name after him, the chicken parm and the Capri salad, and then we have the veal chop, which is Sack's veal chop. How did you get involved with all of this?
I really don't know now that I think about it. You know, actually, this is a great sports town, and Sunday there's a lot of sports bar athletes that are involved. Sunday ends up finding out what they like to eat, and we seem to find a place for them on the menu.
Yeah, you know, this has to be a pretty exciting time for you. I mean, with the acquisition of Theo, a guy that you knew from playing juniors. As a matter of fact, you even went to the airport to pick him up, I understand. It's got to be nice to welcome an old buddy here.
Yeah, it is. When I heard the news, Pierre Lacroix actually phoned me in the morning of the trade and told me we were getting him. So it was a little bit of a shocker. I don't think anybody expected to have Theo here. We kept hearing reports about him going to Detroit or Dallas or somewhere out east. But we felt the same way as when he told us we acquired Patrick Waugh. So it's the same type of feeling here in the dressing room.
What role do you see him playing on this team? And more importantly, what role do you see him having here in the playoff run you guys are about to embark on?
Well, obviously he's one of the best players in the game, so he's got a pretty big role here on this team now, and you know, making that trade obviously puts us up one of the top contenders in the league, and you know, hopefully we can all gel as a team and really come together and put on a good performance in the playoffs.
Obviously Theo has Stanley Cup experience, as do you. From your experience winning the Cup, what would you say is the most valuable thing that you learned that you will now take with you as you guys try to do it again this year?
I think just having that playoff experience, you know, you're going to have momentum changes all the time, and you have your highs and lows in the playoffs, and you just have to stay on an even keel and make sure you prepare yourself for every game. I think the next night's a new night, and you have to be at your best if you expect to win.
Tell me about that personally, from your experience. I mean, what did it take out of you? I mean, the whole playoff run, and then you know, and then the finals. Is it take a tremendous amount of concentration, discipline? I mean, there's like a circus-like atmosphere just surrounding the team the entire time.
Yeah, you know what, as you're playing, you don't feel it. You're going on adrenaline, and every game, every round, there's just that much more excitement, so you don't really feel it until it's over. And when it's over and you realize you can't wake up for the next week, then you find out that it was pretty emotionally draining. But during the experience, during the playoffs, is just so much excitement. You know, that's when you want to play hockey.
As a captain of the team, you were the first to hoist the Stanley Cup over your head and hand it to your teammates. Describe what that felt like.
Oh, it was a dream come true. I think as a kid, you always dream about playing in those types of games and winning the Stanley Cup. So it was definitely a great experience and a thrill of my lifetime.
New Jersey mot Pittsburgh, där har ni ett av de tuffare mötena i slutspelet med stjärnor i mängder. En av dem är Peter Sikora i New Jersey, het som en bastu i första matchen.
How about that goal? Peter Sikora!
Sorry, with a backhand pass across. They score!
Jay Pandolfo fick sedan avgöra öppningsmatchen i tom kasse.
Hutchling for it is Pandolfo. Will he get there first?
The New Jersey Devils, a 3-1 winner.
Good win for this young hockey club.
I match nummer två saknades Jaromir Jagr, men Pittsburgh lyckades vinna ändå.
Gave it across to Straka. He's got Brown in front, and it went off of him. And then Oberlein knocked him down a shot. Hall, score! Miller looks to the slot, has Andrinsak, score!
Martin Straka gjorde ett mål när Penguins vann med 4-1, och han fortsätter dominera i tredje matchen.
Straka, big shot, scores! Ekholm shot, saved by Brodeur, rebound, score! Long shot blocked from Sanderson. Straka goes to the empty net. Straka, hat-trick! A hat-trick for Marty Straka!
Philadelphia är i slutspel utan Erik Lindros. Därför får laget lita till målvakten John Van Beesbrouck i matcherna mot Toronto. Flyers ägde också den andra matchen, men Mats Sundin klev fram och avgjorde för Toronto. I Carolina är det slutspel för första gången. Motståndarna i en fullsatt hemmahall var Boston.
If there was any concern about what the atmosphere would be like for the first ever Stanley Cup playoff game in the state of North Carolina, don't be worried. A sea of red and white.
Matchen var länge mållös, men långt in i tredje perioden kom första målet av Rob DiMeo. Ken Ballinger avslutade målskyttet och Boston vann första mötet, men Carolina kom tillbaka i match två där laget hämtade upp ett underläge i slutminuterna. Ottawa och Buffalo möttes precis som 1997 då Buffalo vann mötet i den sjunde och avgörande matchen.
Here's Barada behind the net trying to center. Five Pekka scores. Michael Pekka. Here's a chance. Benton scores. Sends it across to Shitnik. Rifled that shot just wide. Pekka in front. Brown scores. Buffalo will clear it down the ice and will steal game one.
Buffalo seger i första matchen. Den andra avgjordes i sudden death. Miroslav Chatan hette segerskytten.
Chatan has some room. The defense was changing. Good out there. Now a shot. They score! Miro Chatan ends it for Buffalo. And they go home, leading the series 2-0.
Buffalo vann också tredje matchen mot ett då tungt Ottawa.
Pekka behind the net. Trying to spin away from Yashin. Here's one.
Pittsburghs Jaromir Jagr åkte på en benskada i första matchen mot New Jersey. Den kan hindra honom i resten av slutspelet.
His playing status will be decided on a day-to-day basis.
I gotta get some treatment from the doctors. Get acupuncture again because it helped me before, and see what happens tomorrow.
Carolinas Ron Francis har en ledbandsskada i höger fot. Den gör hans medverkan osäker.
Watch that right ankle again. Oh boy. Man, that hurts.
And a Philadelphia player injured along the boards.
Philadelphias Valeri Selepukin åkte in i sargen mot Toronto och skadade sitt högra knä. I samma match bröt Torontos Igor Koroljev benet i en kollision med sargen och Flyers Dan McGillis. Koroljev har spelat färdigt för i år. Colorados Alexei Gusarov skadade knät efter en kollision med lagkompisen Theo Fleury i första matchen mot San Jose. Gusarovs status är osäker. Efter 4 år som head coach i LA fick Larry Robinson sparken när laget missade slutspelet. Nu en tillbakablick på säsongen 98-99 där en hel del NHL-rekord har slagits, bland annat av Ray Bourque i Boston.
Ray Bourque gets the assist, number 1050, that surpasses Gordie Howe and puts Bourque alone in third place on the NHL's all-time list. A standing ovation. The Red Wings are leaning over their bench and tapping their sticks on the boards.
Bourque har också gjort flest mål i NHL bland backar, 385 stycken. Den 5 februari fick publiken i Detroit uppleva ett par imponerande saker, till exempel Larry Murphys bedrift.
When the puck is dropped, he will have played more games as a defenseman in the National Hockey League than anyone ever. His 1,447th Patrick Waugh has become only the 5th goaltender in NHL history to win 400 games.
Patrick Roy är bara 35 vinster från det stora rekordet som Terry Sawchuk har i NHL med 447 segrar. 10 spelare gjorde sin 1000:e match den här säsongen. Det gjorde också Tampa Bay's coach Jack Demare. NHL Power Week gratulerar allihopa.
I want to thank the players of this game because of the wonderful performances that they're about to give and that they've given all season long. Thank you very much. Enjoy the game.
Under säsongen har 2 spelare kommit upp i 1000 poäng. Washington's Brian Bellows och Dallas Brett Hull.
Brett Hull and Bobby Hull become the first father-son combination in National Hockey League history to each register 1000 points in this game.
Hulls lagkompis Joe Nieuwendijk är en av dem som gjort historiska mål i år.
Nieuwendijk, he scores! There it is! Number 400 for Joe Nieuwendijk!
And there it is! Number 400 is in for the Ultimate Warrior, Rick Tocchet.
Rosa in the slot, Rosa to Robitaille! Score! Number 400 for Rick Robitaille!
Looking for Messier, there's the shot, he scores!
Årets största händelse är ändå att hockeyns nummer 1 sagt adjö för gott.
Linden is pressured. Gretzky in front. Saved by Flaherty. The rebound. Score!
Number 1072 for Wayne Gretzky. All time.
And how about that? Another milestone, but a great one. He now stands on the bench. And the people are standing in the garden.
Nu ska ni få träffa årets främsta europeiska målskyttar i NHL. En av dem är slovaken Pavel Demitra i St. Louis.
Pavel Demitra has played a lot.
Oh, he's been a big pleasant surprise. He showed signs of it last year, but this year he's taken it to a whole another level. A kid can really shoot the puck. He ripped that one.
Yate gets the puck, works in over to Demitra, he shoots and scores.
And here's Turgeon over the line with Demitra, shot, he scores. Pavel Demitra. Demitra scores.
37 mål i grundserien blev det. Ännu bättre var Ottawas Alexei Yashin som ni får se i hockey-VM i Norge.
And if they're going to go anywhere, they're going to need Alexei Yashin to play the way he has all season long.
2-on-1, moving in, passing to the third man for another goal. Yashin, where else? He comes out of nowhere.
Top of the circle, he swipes to the corner. Yashin drives it and scores. Alexei Yashin.
Yashin gjorde 44 mål och 50 assist och blev tredje bästa europé i poängligan. Tvåa var Peter Forsberg, Colorados bästa poängplockare.
Forsberg is after it. In a race. Oh, unbelievable! He scores! Forsberg out of front. He scores! Unbelievable goal by Forsberg!
Now Kometsky to Forsberg. In a clear. Oh, he scores!
30 mål och hela 67 passningspoäng blev det för Peter Forsberg i år. Timo Selänne var ännu värre. Ligans bästa målskytt fick nyinstiftade Maurice Richard Trophy.
Solani glides around Madonna. Inside the zone. He wants. Slap shot and a goal!
Counter punching is Solani. Around the defense he winds. He shoots, he scores! Teemu Solani!
47 mål och 60 assist för Selänne. Imponerande, men ändå 20 poäng sämre än poängligans vinnare. poäng gav Jagr hans tredje poängligaseger på 5 år. Slutspel innebär att världens tuffaste liga blir ännu tuffare. Här är det bästa i tacklingsväg.
Not find a finer hit than that there.
Here's Primo looking to go wide. Cutting him with a chance to fall the save and rebound. Martin Shemina fired it wide. Roberts, he has Kapanen in cross. He bounces back on him with a chance. What a save by Byron Defoe. Here's the penalty shot. It's all yours.
Straka finds the seam, cuts through, cuts in, Straka, drop pass, great save right there!
Oh, big glove by Marty.
Amazing stop by Hatcher.
Alfredson gets it ahead, Lofton it on the move, heat it up.
Rebound!
Nästa vecka får ni träffa muskelpaketet Rick Tocchet i Phoenix.
I've always been a workout guy, but I've never been more serious than I have in the last last four years, where, you know, I just had to make a decision. If I want to play a lot more years in the NHL, I'd have to do this, and it's prolonged my career.